What's up, guys, and welcome. It's Inferno Kun. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, or whatever you are celebrating today. I wanted to make a little special video looking back at Telltale in 2014. I know The Walking Dead and The Wolf Among Us came out in 2013, but they finished in 2014, so might as well go ahead and add them in. So this is my top 10 favorite scenes from Telltale's games. Awesome games, going to involve The Wolf Among Us, Walking Dead Season 2, Tales from the Borderlands, and Game of Thrones. So, hope you guys enjoy, and let's go. Number 10 is going to be the scenes where basically Luke and Clem are scouting ahead in The Walking Dead Season 2, Episode 2, A House Divided. Now, there are multiple scenes where they're walking, talking about family, taking on these two walkers, and them on the bridge. Now, personally, the one on the bridge is my favorite. Now, before then, it was definitely more about Clementine and Luke developing this kind of partner relationship, kind of like how Lee and Clem were back in episode 3 of season 1 when they were in that train station and they were working together. But instead, you're with this guy you just met probably a week ago, and the fact that Clementine really isn't that little girl she was back in season 1, she's able to not rely on her Lee figure so much and just handle herself if she's in a walker encounter. Now, that's really where it felt like awesome to me, like having Luke be in trouble down there, Clementine, you know, handling the walkers on top of the bridge while Luke's down there almost about to fall into the river. And that was pretty awesome. I love that scene. It was definitely one of my favorite scenes Telltale has made, showing that Clementine could actually handle herself in a walker encounter and also save her friend.
Thanks, Clem.
Number 9 definitely goes to Ramsay Snow's arrival in Iron Wrath on Game of Thrones Episode 1, Iron from Ice. This scene was the epitome of Game of Thrones, definitely what happened in the show. Ramsay Snow is not a person to be reasoned with, and the Foresters had to find that out the hard way. And then seeing that this was all caused by Garrett indirectly just made me go like, what? Because like, Garrett, you know, kill that Bolton soldier, and now we have Ramsay Snow coming to Iron Wrath to have the Lord answer for what he did, and it ended up with Ethan dying and Ryan getting taken away, and basically half, or depending on your choices, probably half of the Ironwood getting taken by the White Heels. It's just so much unexpected things that happened in this scene that made it so good but bad at the same time. Good in terms of storytelling, but bad for the Foresters, and that just made it a really great, strong, emotional scene. Made you kind of feel like you were, you know, just worried about what's gonna happen because of Ramsay Snow being the crazy bastard that he is.
Lovely meeting all of you. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Number 8 goes to Reese and his son Loderbot in Tales from the Borderlands Episode 1 Zero Sum. This scene was downright awesome, having the Loderbot come and just totally wreck stuff up. Also, it has some funny lines between, you know, Vaughn, Reese, and definitely the Loderbot too. It was definitely a lot of humor in this, definitely a lot of action, having it be very bloody with a bunch of combat during the Loderbot scenes, and it just made it so awesome being in control of the Loderbot, just having it wreck all these bandits. And then the most awesome part definitely being Reese grabbing his thumb baton and just wrecking those bandits with it, like just destroying them one hit and it's over with them. And it was definitely an awesome scene, just being in power the whole time. Loderbot was wrecking stuff up with my shield, and rockets was definitely causing a lot of havoc and having a lot of fun with it. Definitely grabbing that Borderlands feel of an actual bandit fight, just coming at you with everything they got and still getting wrecked. So that was definitely an awesome scene.
I will name my firstborn Loderbot. Oh, you know. Probably not.
Number 7 goes to Bigby's rematch with the Woodsmen in The Wolf Among Us Season 1 Episode 1. Now, if you don't know, Wolf Among Us was my first Telltale game, believe it or not. This fight was my first impression on Telltale games, and it was downright amazing. It really got me into loving Telltale, loving this series. It was a very brutal fight and a very awesome fight at that. It was just so very well animated, and it was just awesome. Now, for me, being my first impressions on Wolf Among Us, on the Fables universe, I was like, man, this is the Fables universe, like the big bad wolf and all that. That's pretty damn awesome. And then, you know, seeing as how the fight ended off and everything else, it was just so amazing. After he got axed by Fate, I was like, man, he's still alive? And, you know, it just really had a really hard impact on me, being such a brutal fight between Big B and the Woodsman, and it really got me intrigued into Wolf Among Us, so I kept on playing it and I just loved it. So good job, Telltale, A++++ scene right here.
Guy's having a bad day.
That makes two of us. I guess it's a good thing fables are hard to kill.
Suppose it is.
Number 6, the herd scene in The Walking Dead Season 2, Episode 4. This scene got me really scared, really surprised, and really like, what just happened? Like, Sarita getting her arm cut off, if you did that, that was definitely a huge surprise to me. Made me really sorry for Kenny, and really like, damn, Telltale, you did that right then and there, and didn't do anything else at that point. That was like, a wow moment to me. And then having Clementine alone in the herd until they met up with Rebecca and Jane and them. That scene was just so like, it hushed me over me. I was like, what's going on? You know, walkers everywhere, we're covered, and walker good, we're not really seen right now. But it was something that really had you like, what, where's everybody at? What's gonna happen? Why are we still in here? Why can't we just run out? And it was just something really awesome. Now, for the most part, having, you know, Rebecca actually feeling scared really just added on to the moment, like having her really terrified for her life, being in a herd and everything else. Then having Jane, the one who's like an expert at this, like, stay calm, hey, let's go through it. And it was very awesome to see how Jane would have a backup plan with going through with other people, having that cow catcher and everything else. So this scene was definitely well done. It had shock value, it had action, it had that moment of suspense and everything else. So it was definitely a pretty good scene in my opinion.
Let's go.
Number 5, the outside of the Red Wedding in Game of Thrones Season 1, Episode 1, Irons from Ice. Now, this scene was definitely pretty chaotic, pretty awesome, and pretty suspenseful. Now, for the most part, having Garrett, a guy who's just a squire, having so much, you know, so much bravery, like going at those soldiers with that shield, taking them on in the fight, was definitely pretty awesome to see Garrett actually doing what other squires wouldn't really be too brave enough to do. That definitely adds to his character, adds to the scene being so awesome. Him escaping everything, him and Lord Forrester actually having a little emotional scene. I mean, like, a lot of stuff happened. You have people dying left and right. You had Lord Forrester get killed, and then you have his son, Roderick, actually possibly getting killed also in a very brutal way, having a horse fall on top of him. Now, this was definitely a great chaotic scene that would happen in Game of Thrones if it was in the show, but I can imagine it being a lot bloodier and more detailed. So good job, Telltale, doing as much as you can with this scene. It was definitely cool to see a more detailed approach to what happened while the Starks were inside of the place.
Hey, it's those foresters!
Oh, your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
Number 4 goes to my second most hyped up Big B moment in The Wolf Among Us Season 1, Episode 3. This scene, the Big B versus Tweedles moment, human in werewolf form, or I should say full werewolf. Now, for the most part, this scene was downright awesome. I remember seeing it for the first time. It was just so sweet. Throwing things at them, you know, throwing them around, hitting them into fuse boxes. It just felt so awesome being in so much power over them. They couldn't do anything about it, and their bullets weren't really doing anything to Big B, so that made it even more satisfying. Actually, you know, not a feeling or barely feeling the bullets being shot into you. It just felt so awesome. So even having, you know, a choice to either kill them, which I did, and it just was so brutal, so detailed, and it really made it like more suspenseful seeing Snow White so surprised by Big B going into this mode and wrecking up the Tweedles and being this uncontrollable monster that he probably is in her eyes. So it was definitely a lot of action, a lot of awesome stuff. And then we had to have our fun ruined by Bloody Mary, who shot a silver bullet into Big B. Ended it right there. Bloody Mary ruined the fun.
Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it.
Number three goes to that big chariot race thing where everyone dies. In Tales from the Borderlands episode 10 some. This scene was so expanded due to having two protagonists, having Fiona being on the race, actual race, and then having Reese be in the middle fighting that skag and everything else, trying to get the money back, and then having the case go back into where Fiona is. So definitely was an amazing scene, one of my favorite scenes in Tales from the Borderlands so far. It was just so much going on, so much havoc being caused. It was just so awesome having, you know, Reese use that sword and slice open the skag belly on accident, and then having Fiona go ahead and fight those psychos. It was just so much crazy stuff going on. So awesome. And that's pretty much why I like Borderlands so much. It's just so crazy, so unpredictable, and just so random. So definitely Telltale did a good job with this scene, having it have so much variety to it. Having psychos everywhere, having skags, having Bossa Nova actually be there wrecking up Zero, trying to wreck up Zero. And it was just pretty awesome. So in return, Zero freaking wrecked him, and it was just a fun time. Definitely an awesome chariot race thing, awesome idea. So definitely one of my favorite scenes. Pretty awesome.
Bossa Nova's dead. I don't think he was lying. Gordas is not here.
Don't sweat it, babe. That's one less bandit lord we have to worry about. There's plenty of time for sweating later, once you come back to me for your reward.
My quest is not done.
My reward for you is gonna be long, hard, and powerful.
Gordas remains out of reach.
It's a rocket launcher.
Yes, innuendo.
Number two goes to Carver showing up at the ski lodge in The Walking Dead Season 2, Episode 2. This scene was just so much suspense. It just really was suspenseful at the fact. It was just like everything got quiet. You know, Clementine sneaking around, Rebecca hiding, Kenny off somewhere, Luke off somewhere too. And then you have Carver walking in the ski lodge trying to like take over everybody and had them all lined up. It was just so awesome in the way you had Carver torturing Carlos, which was horrible. You had Sarah screaming her lungs out for her dad, and it just made it feel like it was just so bad. It made you feel sorry for her in a way, and it was just so awesome. It added to the choice of, you know, going to find Kenny or giving up. Like, it just made you feel like, man, what if he kills Carlos? You know, or I should go find Kenny. And it just made it so much more like, what should I do? Made it more of a hard choice to me. And it was definitely awesome. That scene was just well executed, well done. Made it feel very, very, very intimidating. And it was just really, really awesome. I really love that scene so much. It served its purpose to actually make you feel empty inside and be like, man, I'm scared. This guy's the real talk. And it was just so awesome. So definitely one of my favorite scenes in the entire season. It was just so well done. It made me feel so scared inside, and it was actually done very well.
Where's Luke? Finally cut and run, huh? Why am I not surprised? I warned you. I warned you not to follow him. Look where he's led you. But you're safe now. We're going home. As a family.
Number one, my most favorite Telltale scene of 2014, the most epic fight in The Wolf Among Us, goes to Bloody Mary versus Bigby in The Wolf Among Us Season 1, Episode 5, Cry Wolf. This scene was amazing. Of all the fights in The Wolf Among Us, this is by far the best fight ever. You have Bloody Mary, someone who is said to be very, very intimidating, very scary, very smart, and very, like, awesome, really. An awesome villain at that. And she was just so intimidating you, trying to scare you throughout the whole fight. And when she finally turned into her, you know, true form, that's when the real stuff happened. It was just one of the best fights in The Wolf Among Us. Definitely had a lot of twists to it. You had her actually having clones of herself. You had her actually, you know, just outsmarting you, trying to trick you with her clones. jumping on you. And then when you're finally sick of her games, you finally go into your true wolf form and begin to wreck Mary. And you're just fighting like seeing a giant puppy, basically. Your giant wolf just, you know, swatting Mary and wrecking her and just like, you know, jumping on, biting everything. Just like, it was just words to not explain how awesome that battle was. It was just so awesome seeing two Fables, you know, fight it out, and seeing like two very renowned and strong Fables fight it out like full form fight it out. It was just so amazing. It was just one of the best things about Wolf Among Us. The fighting is just so great, and this one was not to be dealt easily. This was one of the most best things ever. So good job, Telltale, with this fight. It made the last episode the best episode in my opinion, and it was just so worth it. So, number one scene right here. That is it, guys. That is my top 10 most favorite scenes in the Telltale games. Definitely an awesome company. Definitely one of my favorite companies. And damn, Telltale is just awesome. So thank y'all for watching. I wonder how Telltale will do with Game of Thrones and Tales from the Borderlands in 2015. And you can't forget Minecraft Story Mode. Let's see what they do with that. Anyways, We need a season 3 though, that Walking Dead season 3, that would be amazing to come out in 2015. Come on, Telltale, 2015 or 2016, whichever makes the game better. If it's better in 2016, I will wait that long just to have a better season. So, thank you guys for watching. If you guys did enjoy, leave a thumbs up. It helps out tremendously. Be sure to leave a comment of your favorite scenes in Telltale games. You can do any of them from 2014 if you guys want to. Thank you all for watching. This has been InfernoKun, and I'm out.